everybody, Gary here with Pal Music, and that was me playing Jimi Hendrix solo on Born Under a Bad Sign from the Blues album, the second track on that amazing album. This song is an 8-minute jam session, no vocals, just total jammage, and that was just the first minute and a half. So if you want to learn the rest of the solo, be sure to subscribe. If you want the tab and the song notes to go along with this lesson, those are available on my Patreon page, and the link is right below. All right, so let's go over this phrase by phrase. We're gonna deconstruct all these little tricks that Jimmy is doing, where they come from in the pentatonic scale shapes and that kind of thing. This way you can really make them your own and incorporate them into your own playing. All right, let's jump right in. All right, so we're in the key of B flat minor pentatonic. So here's the scale shapes we're gonna use. We're gonna start over here. On that B flat. That's on the 13th fret of the A string. Then we're gonna move down to this shape. First shape of the pentatonic. We're going to visit the House of Blues a lot. Lots of action over there. We're going to have some color tones. This one happens a lot. It's the ninth. Lots of ninths in here. Then we also are going to modulate on the five chord to... So we're in the shape of that five chord. We'll go over that when we get there. All right, first riff. We got a volume swell on the 16th of the B string. It's gonna be a whole step bend. Then hammer 14 to 16 on that B. And then come on the 15th of the G. And then do a dramatic kind of double whole step bend. And that is on the 14th of the B, so. But with the swell. Then we slide it down. Slide it down. Then we come into this shape. Here we go, then it's like a really dramatic whole step bend and then vibrato, nice wide vibrato. I like to go down on that, it could go up. It's so dramatic that it sounds like he might be using the whammy on it. Like I feel like I haven't seen Jimmy do a lot of down bends like that, but anyway, that's how I got closest to the sound. And then, so, so that riff, double stop here. And that's, and then, very funky. So six on the E, then nine, six, nine to six on the B, then six to eight on the G, then skip over the D string and play the eighth on the A string. And then there, so, and then that's the sixth fret on the G string, and then we do this, just kind of like tags it, And that is just a double pull-off kind of a thing. You could pick them all if you want, but it's just very like... So, all together so far. Then we come up to here. Full step bend and then vibrato. That's the 9th fret of the B string. So. And then, while we got it bent up a whole step, we're gonna hit the 9th fret of the E string. Then we got... Then we're gonna bend it again. Then play it not bent. Then go back and forth between the 6th fret and the 9th fret on that B string. So bend, play, 6, 9, 6. Then this thing. You're going to want to have this first finger barred on these two notes so that you can go. Get that kind of thing. And what I like to do is hammer the 6th to the 8th and then sweep up on these two notes on the 6th string. I feel like this riff here and the next one are like so Jimmy. And the fingering might not be what you're used to depending on the style you've been playing for a while, but this took me a while to get this. So far we got... Next riff, he's bending up to that note here. First time he plays them separate, then he plays them together and kind of starts off kind of dissonant, but then as you bend it, they match. And then that, it's... And again, it's all about barring these two. And make use of hammer-ons and pull-offs on there. So, hammer, hammer. These double pull-offs. I mean, you could pick it. So before we get to that part, let's review here. Does this walk down to get to the 5 chord. And there's the first chord change. The 5 chord. And then is 6 8 6 8 9 6 9. Then on this on the E string, 4 6 1. Just slide down here. Then he comes back up here. And these are like, you know, little pull-offs. First one is da da da. Second one da da da. Then he does that cool, this cool chromatic thing. 6 6 8 on the D string, and then 7 6, and then back to that 9th fret on the E. Then classic Jimmy. This little hammer-on thing. Do it as fast as you can. I can't do it that fast. From 6 to 8. And then he does the bass line here. You know, so that's... That's what the bass is playing, and then he joins in. And to make it a little more bluesy, instead of going, he goes. So, gives that one a little bend. Then gives this one some vibrato. Now vibrato on the first string is tough because you can't go down at all. You can only go up. And then... So this is really like a minor arpeggio. But he adds this note. So. So he's just outlining that chord. But adding that note. So it's 6 9 6. Thanks for checking out this lesson. If you are ready for bars 13 through 24, Jimmy's second go around on this awesome solo, that is in the part 2 video. If you want the tab or the interactive Guitar Pro GPX file that you could use in Guitar Pro or on a site like Songster so that you could hear the tab in action, that is all available on my patreon.com PAL Music page for anyone that's a PAL Music patron. All right, happy playing, and I'll see you guys soon.